Now, first, let's enable this Archmesh add-in and get a rough idea of how to use it. To do this, first, open the Blender preference and select the add-ons section. Then, select Add Mesh in the add-ons category selection here. Now enable the Archmesh add-on here and close the Blender preference window. We have now enabled the add-on we want. Before creating a lamp using this add-on, let's get a rough idea of the properties of the add-on and its values. For that, let's clear the viewport first. Now go to the new section called Archmesh in the Add menu. If there is no option called Archmesh, go back to Blender Preference and check if the enabled add-on is correct. This option contains the lamp item in the Decoration section. Now let's add this and zoom in the viewport to see the added lamp. We can adjust all the data of the lamp through this operator panel at the bottom. If you add a lamp and perform other functions in the viewport, such as scaling or moving objects in the viewport, this properties panel will be lost, and another panel will appear instead. Therefore, do not do any other work until the lamp modeling is done. If this panel is lost, by clicking on an object here, this panel can be retrieved using the F9 hotkey. Now let's take a quick look at the properties available here. This lamp can be divided into two main parts. That is the lamp base and the lampshade. The adjustment of the lamp base can be done through this section, and all the adjustments of the lampshade can be done through this section. The height, segment, and rings of the lamp. Here the H value changes the height of the lamp. The segment value. Before changing the segment size, let's switch the viewport to wireframe view. Then you can easily see how the segments changes in the viewport. To see the operation of the rings value here, uncheck the subdivide and smooth checkboxes below this value. This allows you to toggle the smoothness and subdivision of the lamp base, just like the names on these checkboxes. Now you can see how the lamp base rings value changes in the viewport. You can also see how the values of R and S in the properties below change according to this value. This value adds horizontal rings to the lamp base. Accordingly, at the bottom adds individual properties related to these rings. And this is the height adjustment property of the lamp holder. Right now, I will set all the values as before here. And when you enable subdivide without enabling smoothness, you can see how this base is subdivided. Let us now look at these R and S values. These are the radio values of the rings. This will change the scale of the relevant ring. These are the Z indexing values of these rings. This will changes the vertical offset of the relevant rings. The predefined property. You can select a predefined lamp base design through this predefined property. This is the height adjustment property of the lampshade. Here, R1 and R2 are the scaling properties of the bottom and top rings of the lampshade. This segment property sets vertical segments for the lampshade. Now I give the size of 4 segments here. You can see the shade smoothness of this lampshade still exists. For now, keep in mind that shade smoothness can be flattened by this pleats option. In the next parts of this video, when modeling a lamp, you will know how to properly handle this pleats property. The light, translucency, and create cycles material checkbox. These allow for inbuilt material adjustments that come with this lamp. We do not need to know about these properties due to the redesign of the material for these lamps in the upcoming parts of this lesson. Right now you have a rough idea of these properties. When making several lamps using this panel, you will have a better knowledge of how to handle these properties better. So, don't bother to remember all these properties now. In the next session, we will see how to create lamps using this add-on.